Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, when it comes to fast food dining, people just don't care how many calories are in their Big Macs. American Journal of Public Health recently published a new study which shows the calorie consumption hasn't dropped since fast food chains started posting nutrition information on the menus. New York City began requiring chains like McDonald's to post calorie counts on menus back in 2008. But according to this study, it looks like people are not turning away from the higher calorie choices. I was in one of those, I usually don't go to the fast food places, but it was one of those things where we were in, I was getting ready to get something, and you look up at the board, and I was like, that looks fantastic, but whoa.
It scares you.
It's like a horror movie.
It shocks you sometimes.
What's gonna happen next?
Just how many calories are in just one part of your day, just one, you know, tiny burger, if you will. I have to tell you, if I have a craving for something like a burger, because I'm like you don't have them all the time, so you gotta go for it sometimes. But I think this is super helpful for a lot of people that do like to just be mindful of how many calories they're taking in. Maybe they will splurge on that, but knowing how many calories are in that meal, they might make up for it either before or after in the day.
Even some of those places where you go and you sit down and you think you're having a healthy meal, I think it should be posted on there, because a lot of the salads that you think you're having, the salad's fine. As soon as you put the dressing on, it tastes so good. Or the bacon bits or everything else that I like, that everybody else likes. That's when it puts the calories through the roof. Yeah.
I think it's helpful because it educates people a little bit more. And, you know, I don't really know, because I personally don't necessarily look at those calorie count things. But I think that for some people who maybe they are trying to diet, or maybe they, you know, just had a baby or something and they're trying to get back to their weight, so they just need a little Kickstarter. And this if this helps, then I think that's great. I think more education on food and what you put in your body is super helpful. With me, I've tried a lot of things, and I just find that moderation is key. Because I will totally splurge on something because I want to eat it, and then I just am able to like make up for it later. And
I'm the worst at a restaurant, though. I'll look at the menu and be so torn between things. That sounds good, and so does that. So sometimes when that happens and I'm torn between two dishes, and it will tell you how much.
You tell somebody else that you want to split it.
Yeah, right. That's, you know, that makes the decision easier for me. I'll go with the one that's a couple less calories. I've done that before.
I think it's the only thing. I have, like, these two guys, they know. I have zero willpower. Zero. None.
Even with his name being Will.
Even with my name being willpower, I have no willpower. Yesterday, someone brought in some desserts, and I walked past. I was like, oh, no, I'm not going to have it. And they said, well, it's from this place. I stopped dead in my tracks and couldn't spin around quick enough to grab one of them and eat it. And that's the truth.
And I was bumped into them, so
yeah, I was going to say, I'm so glad there wasn't someone walking behind you.
Because we would have plowed right into each other. I have zero willpower when it comes to pastries and all this other stuff. Absolutely.
Needless to say, I think they're helpful. I don't think they should go anywhere. But I'm going to eat what I want.
Right.
Yeah. Well, our Facebook friends and our Twitter followers, they weighed in as well on this. And here's what some are saying. Kristen Courier says, not really. When you go out to eat, you want something good for the occasion. It's like a break from the healthy norm at home.
Exactly. Get something that you wouldn't have at home.
That's a good way to put it. Michelle Nelson Paulette tells us that not the calories, but the carb, fat, and protein content are what govern my decision.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Margie Elifsades weighs in with, I usually order what I'm in the mood for, and if the portion is too big, then I don't eat at all. It's a good idea for restaurants to have it on their menu because some people can't eat certain ingredients.
Or you can take half at home for leftovers.
That's true.
Always
portion
a good idea.
Control is key.
See, I'd be doing that, but eating it like 20 minutes later when I get home.
That defeats the purpose, Will. Jackie Hennessy tells
zero willpower.
It helped me make healthier choices while vacationing in Seattle recently, where, get this, posting calories on menu is a law.
Interesting.
It's the law.